The athletes arriving for London 2012 will be putting their bodies through enormous strain, therefore they will require excellent medical help. The London 2012 Polyclinic has been designed specifically for their purposes.
The Polyclinic in any Olympics is the centre of medical treatment for all the athletes. It's the jewel in the crown of the medical services. And here we have the most fantastic jewel. It is a large building. It's got everything in it, all the facilities that team doctors or athletes would want, absolutely conveniently in the village, so they can be treated and investigated and sorted out very efficiently and very conveniently for them, and hopefully get to the starting line in great shape.
The Polyclinic is very big because it's going to be a primary healthcare centre after the Games. So it's 5,000 square metres. So we've been able to absorb some services that wouldn't normally be here at Games time. So for example, the sports massage therapy is here rather than somewhere else in the village. And also our colleagues in anti-doping have a large area on the second floor. So they've been able to utilise space here as well. So in actual fact, it's a very well used building at Games time, but is in keeping for what it's going to be used afterwards.
There'll be 600 team doctors coming over with all those Olympic athletes, and they will look to us, as I did in the past, for all those facilities they need to make sure they can provide the best possible care. So our scanning, the GE scanners, of the CT scanner and the two MRI scanners, the ultrasound, all the pathology, that's going to be really crucial, and it needs to be very quick as well, so they can make those decisions about coming back and about the sort of training they can and can't do.
Potential scenario would be some athlete who had an injury out of the venue and there was a suspected fracture, and we would have take an x-ray here. It's digital, there's a viewing room on the first floor, so all the clinicians would be able to look at the x-ray right away and deal with it, and then the person would be treated on site.
Well, the most common, particularly in athletes, is obviously musculoskeletal injuries. So it's your sprains and strains. A few will have more serious injuries, as in fractures or major joint injuries, but most, hopefully, are minor, acute or overuse injuries. Then there are lots of minor illnesses. And you might think, well, what does a minor illness matter? Most of us carry on with a cold. But if you're an athlete trying to perform absolutely to the peak of your ability, then actually getting through that as quickly as you can and putting yourself in as good a shape as possible is really important. We estimate at the peak around 200 athletes a day will come through, and then we'll also be looking after the support staff, so probably about 400 patients at the peak in a single day.